Hey guys, you see Arsenal here. Glad you made it to the fifth episode of 2 Minute Health Food Hacks, where we'll be discussing sage. I haven't uploaded one of these in a while, and I thought it's time to jump back into the series. I really like doing these videos, and if you like watching and learning from them, please subscribe, like, and hit the bell to be notified of all my other 2 Minute Health Food Hack episodes I have coming up for you guys, where I discuss a specific food item, what it is, who it is good for, who it is not good for, what its benefits are, and whether or not you should incorporate it into your diet, all under 2 minutes. So without further ado, let's start that timer. Now, sage refers to the plants from the genus Salvia, which contains about 900 different species. They share the same origin as the mint family alongside other herbs like oregano, rosemary, basil, and thyme. The two species commonly used as traditional remedies are common sage and Spanish sage. It is used as a natural cleaning agent, a pesticide, and often in rituals where it is burnt. More so, it has medicinal benefits for people with mild to moderate Alzheimer's disease at 1 gram a day, as it improves cognitive function when used up to 4 months. It also helps to enhance memory, as clinical research in healthy older adults show that taking a single dose of common sage extract at 333 milligrams improved secondary memory compared with placebo. Further than this, cognitive performance was also improved when taking a single dose of Spanish sage essential oil at 25 to 50 microliters prior to a cognitive test, which the results showed an improvement in attention and alertness when compared to placebo. That is all due to its constituents 1-8-cineol, alpha-pinene, and caryophyllene epoxide, which all have anticholinesterase activity. These substances stop the breakdown of acetylcholine between the nerve synapses, which help promote neuronal conduction in the brain, which is believed to slow the progression of Alzheimer's. In vitro research also suggests that the rosmaritic acid from sage can protect pheochromocytoma cells from amyloid beta peptide-induced neurotoxicity, which may also protect you from developing Alzheimer's. So besides for its amazing benefits it provides the brain, sage isn't for everyone, as it requires you to monitor your sugars carefully if you are diabetic and if you have hormone-sensitive cancers, because it can have estrogenic effects. Common sage has been shown to lower blood pressure, while Spanish sage has been shown to increase it. So watch your blood pressures carefully if you are taking it. Also, high amounts of sage can lead to convulsions as well. So definitely watch consumption closely if you have any seizure disorders. But overall, sage taken orally seems to be well tolerated. Some side effects have been reported in clinical trials, including nausea and vomiting and upset stomach. So talk to your doctor before trying it out and let me know what you use it for, or if you incorporate it into your food at all in any way, in the comment section below. This isn't a full list because it is under 2 minutes, but I hope that you learned something and enjoyed the video. And if you did, please give it a like and subscribe. And as always, thanks for watching.